Now, so I'm proposing something different from psychology. I'm proposing happiness or suffering. See? Psychology say, pursue happiness, avoid pain. I'm saying, no. Happiness through overcoming suffering. That's very different. Avoiding pain will end up more pain. You can't avoid the unavoidable suffering. The more you try to avoid, the worse it gets. There are research findings showing that. You try to avoid something, you end up having more anxiety, more fear, but still suffer the consequence. But if you confront what you fear, you confront the object of fear and face it and going through the pain, then you come out stronger and better. So that's a big idea, right? You run away from your pain, it causes you more pain. You face your pain and go through it, you come out stronger. Okay. So that's a busy idea. So I'm setting up an institute to do research to generate more evidence. Okay. So that I'm saying the next decade, longer happiness, smiley face, but happiness through suffering. Okay. The new science. Okay. Suffering is a training ground for self-transcendence. If you want to be free from your self-love, free from your bondage, you better come to my suffering camp. Now, why do we need a new science? Because suffering is an inevitable aspect of life. When I get older, I experience more losses. I lost my friend. Not too long ago, Dr. Chen, he was the best man for my wedding. He's a well-known medical doctor. He died. My cousin from New York, supposed to visit me, he died. My best friend get a massive stroke a couple days ago. It can happen to me anytime. All my friends are deserting me. They all die. Next week and next month might be my turn. Who knows? So because this is, also you suffer because of our limitations. We suffer because of our weaknesses. Whether weaknesses for alcohol, or weaknesses for women, or weaknesses for sweet things, our weakness for anything. We all have our weaknesses. There isn't a single person in this world that does not have weaknesses. So if we don't know how to confront and overcome our weaknesses, our limitations, we can never be a better person, okay? Because your weakness will always with you. There's no escape until you confront it. And then there also they're our inner demon. Most of the time, our painful memory, our inner demon are hiding in the unconscious. Carl Jung called that the shadow. If we do not bring the shadow to the consciousness, you continue to haunt you, continue to torment you. So there's a need to face your shadow. So in other words, there is no escape from suffering. That's why Buddhists, the first noble truth of Buddhism is what? Life is suffering. The Bible also says the whole creation travels and groans in suffering. The whole creation. So there's simply no escape, okay? Only the die-hard parapsychologists, they see everything in rose-colored lens. But reality is very bleak, okay? So one good thing about suffering is that we have the natural capacity to search for meaning. I did a very important research at UCLA. At that time, the big question in science is that, do people engage in search for meaning? So I did big research and discovered that people will search for meaning only when bad things happen to them. If everything is going well, they don't bother. But when bad things happen to me, they say, why me? Why now? What went wrong? So, bad thing actually is a good thing, don't know why. Bad thing triggered this search for meaning and lead you to understand life and yourself in a deeper way. Most of the people live an inauthentic life. Heidegger, a philosopher, a famous German philosopher, he said most people live an inauthentic life. They eat and drink and have sex and get happy. They do their things and never dare to look at what life's all about. They're afraid of thinking about death. They're afraid of thinking about everything's empty. So Heidegger says that most people think they're happy, but they are actually living an inauthentic life. They're actually wasting their time. But if you want to be authentic, if you want to know who you really are, if you want to be what you were meant to be, well, you gotta pay a price. You gotta confront the existential anxiety that life is tough. Life is full of pain. Again, the same idea. You have to be able to face pain in order to find yourself. So you want to know your true self? Parapsychology cannot help you. Because you can't find yourself, you cannot find yourself without confronting the dark side of human existence. Without confronting the dark shadow in your soul. It's not possible, okay? And also, suffering contributes to character development and mature happiness, okay? Now, do you remember the Bible says that Jesus is a man of sorrow, okay? But he's also the one who gave us the Sermon on the Mount, saying that, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are those who are suffering persecution for righteousness' sake. So because Jesus is acquainted with sorrow and pain, he understands the deepest joy. Not coming from my escaping, avoiding pain, the joy from confronting pain, from mourning, to know your emptiness, your inner poverty. It is so searching. So the deeper joy that Jesus talked about in the Sermon on the Mount is available only for those will go through suffering and benefit from the redemptive value of suffering. When they're at the end of the rope, they cry out, God, rescue me, save me. So, and then there's redemption, right? So happiness and suffering are inseparable. So that is the new science which particular people are still do not really understand that. Suffering and happiness are inseparable. If you want to happiness, face your suffering. That's my message to the world. Okay? The new science is based on meaning seeking, developing gratitude, and then face. Next minute, I'll talk about gratitude. Gratitude is also a powerful engine to transform your pain, your misery, into thanksgiving. For example, you lost a loved one, you feel pain. You have two choices. You're either complaining, be depressed, suicidal, and some people break up with suicide because of breakup. I one time he wanted to kill himself because he lost a girlfriend. So I told him, I said, you want to kill yourself because of a silly girl who doesn't appreciate your value? Shame on you, I say. Shame on you. You have something, everything going for you. Tall and handsome, intelligent, but kill yourself because you become a stupid girl who doesn't appreciate you. I say, there are tons of girls who are waiting for good men like you. So, so the pain is trying to kill yourself as an escape. But the alternative is to thank God it happened to me. Now I know what kind of woman I look for. Not those women who enjoy fun and excitement, but some woman who appreciate me. Some woman who understand my need. So, consider that suffering as a gift from God. It teaches you to be smarter, knowing what kind of woman is good for life partner. Not every woman. So consider that as a lesson. Don't kill yourself for that. See? Thank God for suffering as a gift. We'll talk about that next month. And so we need new signs, okay, because we're wired for negativity and life is full of suffering. And we need something that can not only reduce our suffering, but give us mature happiness. Now, this is Frankl. So here's my pure way of transformation. This is based on meaning therapy. Pure, do you know what it stands for? Pure means, P means purpose, U means understanding, R means responsibility, and E means emotion, okay? So now I flip it around, okay? Let's start with emotion. You really need to feel the pain, feel the unbearable pain before real change can happen. If there's no pain, no gain, no pain, no gain, you want to change, feel the pain. Imagine what it will cost you, what it will lead you to. Imagine what it will be like when you are at the rock bottom. When at the rock bottom, there's nowhere to go but death. The next step of rock bottom is death. Do you want to help or you stay there and die? So you need to feel the pain in your bone. You need to feel the pain in your guts. You need to feel the pain in your soul, in your heart, before you can change. If you don't feel the pain, oh, I pump the chain, that means nothing. When you experience the pain, you say, I don't love one anymore. Then, the second thing is that you got to take responsibility for change. But now, I'm very careful this point, okay? As I said earlier, do it yourself is not enough. Do you know why? Because you might choose your friends. Your bad company can lead you astray. Stay away from bad company. Right? Oh, I change. But still hang around with a whole bunch of the same guy. You drag your back to the same thing again. Drinking, smoking, or anything. So change is not just solo effort. Change needs social change. Change your company. So structure your change. When you activism to change the inequality, injustice in our society, to make it more fair. So we need social change. But even social change, we need social change, we need social support, but there's no excuse for not making personal change. You are responsible for your own well-being, okay? The understanding. While you're here, you're understanding your role in this world. You're not just thrown in this world by accident. You have a part to play. The world needs you. I need you, Jay. I need you, right? I need you, the young must sing. I need you too, right? I need you. I need you. You need me. We need each other, right? The world needs you. So before you kill yourself, remember the world needs you. This old man needs you. This old man needs you, okay? So we all need each other. Human being is a social ecology. We are part of social ecology. One part is wrong, the whole part is affected, right? So society is an ecology, okay? And the last point, discover an irresistible purpose. Every day, I could hardly wait to get up. I got pain in my joint, I got toothache, everything. I could hardly wait to get out of bed because I have something important to do. That means help suffering people to be free from suffering and to understand happiness. So that's my mission. Okay? So thank you for listening. Bye-bye, online people. I'm limping, right? I'm still going forward. I'm talking without teeth. I'm still talking. And you're better than I, right? You can do more. Okay, bye-bye. I'll just a little rest, I'll come back.